Apparently, there's about to be a tech war over these AI glasses. Well, at least according to the news. And it's looking like this war is going to have three main players. The first player in this war clearly is Meta, obviously. Next up on the list is Google. They just announced their glasses the other week. And then last but not least, we have Apple, who apparently aren't very far behind. So I think it's safe to say that the tech world at least thinks these glasses are going to be the next big thing. But are they actually? I've had these Meta Ray-Ban glasses for just over half a year. And after having used these, I really do think there's a chance these could become the next big thing. Because some of the tech in this is really cool. Now, originally I was gonna showcase some of these features in my studio, but it is such a nice day outside and we don't get many of those in England. So I thought we could go on a little walk. Let's do it. Now, the first thing you might be wondering, are these gonna replace our phones? And the answer to that is no. At this point, they're more akin to like AirPods. These are an accessory to your phone. You can use these to answer phone calls and texts and listen to music. And just like AirPods, you do need to have your phone connected to the glasses to get the full functionality. The glasses actually come with this really nice case, which also act as the glasses' chargers. So when they're out of battery, you simply take them off, fold them away, and you put them in this case. And as you will be able to see, there's this lovely little light that comes up, which tells you that it's charging, which is really cool. Generally speaking, I found the battery life to be pretty good with these, as long as you're not taking tons of videos all the time. And in terms of the battery life of the actual case itself, it lasts for quite a good long while. I have definitely made it through a whole day with these on one charge, but by the end of the day, they were running low. Now, I know some of you may be interested in how loud the speakers go on these things. Maybe you're a bit self-conscious like me, and if you're on the train, you'd be worried about other people hearing your calls or what you're listening to. So I'm gonna play some royalty-free music on my phone through the speakers. The microphone is about 3 feet away from me and I'm gonna slowly raise it up so you can get an idea of how loud these go. We're gonna start at around 10%. Probably can't hear that. 50%. Again, I can still hear everything around me. It's all right, but it's louder. All right, then we've got 75%. It's now starting to drown out the surroundings. 90%. And finally, 100%. So that's quite loud. I can't really hear anything around me anymore. So hopefully that gives you a little idea of how loud these go. Now, I know I've been comparing these a lot to AirPods, so some of you might be wondering, why would you pick a pair of these over AirPods? And the answer to that is this does something that AirPods just simply can't do because of the camera. And that's recording video and taking photos. So if I want to take a photo or a video with these glasses, as you can see right here, there's a little button on top of there. And one click of it will take a photo like this. And if I hold it down for just a second, it'll start taking a video as indicated by this light, and you can see what I'm saying. The video format, as you can see, is 3x4, which is much more suited to vertical video. So for me, as primarily a YouTuber, this makes them less useful for filming. So my options are I could leave it like this and have 2/3 of the screen just be blank, which isn't that great. Or the other option I have is to zoom in the footage until it fills in the screen. But then that means that I'm losing a crop at the top and bottom, and also the video image quality will be less because it's zoomed in, which means I'll probably have to
come up with some interesting ways to fill the space like this.
Now, having said all that, if you're an Instagrammer, a TikToker, a YouTube Shorts-er, these would be kind of perfect for you. I've actually used these glasses for a few upcoming YouTube Shorts where I unbox some things, and for that use case, they're actually perfect.
So while I do find this useful, I do kind of wish it had an aspect ratio of 4x3 instead of 3x4, as that would much better fit my use case. Well, actually, come to think of it, I could just... Okay, yeah, this could work. Kind of walking around. Yeah, look at that tree. That tree looks great. Yeah, I mean, this kind of works. Perfect. Yeah.
Yeah, this is perfect.
One thing that genuinely shocked me with these glasses is how good the image stabilization was when recording videos. I took these things snowboarding with me and I went down like that kind of slalom run, and when I watched back the video, it was so, so smooth. But the problem of showing you that footage on its own is you don't have anything to compare it to, so it doesn't actually give you an idea of how stable the video actually is. But I think I found a way that we can put this to the test.
Here we go!
Okay, one more time. Here we go.
So yeah, hopefully that showed off how good the glasses' stabilization is. But how's about we talk about some of the AI in these AI glasses?
Oh, I want to get a video of that. Look at the fox. See that? You see the fox?
It's not often you see a fox running around during the day. So these glasses have Meta AI built into them, and what that basically means is you have an assistant with you all the time, wherever you go. Basically like Google Assistant, Siri, or Alexa. But once again, it's the camera in these things along with the AI that make these glasses interesting. Let's imagine an example where you find yourself in a car park and you need to remember where you parked. And I've got this little recorder which will hopefully pick up what Meta is gonna say to me. So you'd simply say, hey Meta, look and remember where I've parked.
You have parked in a parking lot with a gate and a fence surrounding it. There are trees and bushes nearby, and the sky is cloudy.
That's about right, yeah. And you might be wondering, and yes, my voice assistant does sound like John Cena, because it is John Cena. You know there's that meme where everyone thinks John Cena is invisible? He's not actually invisible, he's just been in my glasses the whole time.
Are you sure about that?
Alright, that's cool and all, but let's take it up a notch. Let's imagine you're on holiday in Spain and you've gone to a really nice restaurant, but the menu is all in Spanish, and there's no English translation. If you're like me, that's kind of your worst nightmare. Well, these glasses should be able to translate it for me. And to test this, I've got two menus here, one in Spanish and one in English, so I'm going to ask it to translate the Spanish one for me, and let's see how well it does. So I simply look at the menu and go, hey Meta, look and translate this menu for me. Takes a photo. I'm going to swap to the English one.
Here's
as he
reads
it.
Here's the translation of the menu. Menu of the day, appetizers, tortilla soup, yep. Spicy broth with corn, avocado, and cheese. Nopala salad, fresh nopales, tomato, onion, and cilantro.
Yep.
Main course is tacos, al pastor,
yep.
Marinated pork, pineapple, onion, and salsa.
Yeah.
Green enchiladas, tortillas filled with chicken, covered in green sauce and cream. Veracruz style fish, fish fillet with tomato sauce, olives, and capers.
Yep.
Desserts, vanilla flan, creamy egg dessert with caramel. Rice pudding, rice cooked in milk with cinnamon and raisins.
Yep.
Beverages, horchata, sweet rice drink with cinnamon.
That's correct.
Mango juice, fresh and natural mango juice. Coffee, traditional coffee with piloncillo and spices.
And there you go. But then what if the waiter is Spanish and doesn't know any English? Well, these glasses can also do live translations as well. Now, I don't have a Spanish person here to help me with it, but what I can do is describe how it works. So you would start the live translation on your phone, and then the waiter would speak to you in Spanish. That would be translated and said to you in your ears via the translator. Then you would speak in English your response, and your response would be then shown in Spanish on your phone, which you can then show to the waiter. Now, I haven't had a chance to try this personally yet, but if the translation of the menu says anything, I think it should work pretty well. Okay, I swear this is the last time I'm gonna do this, but I've discovered something really cool. I think you can actually use the live translation feature of these glasses to help you learn a language. So I'm currently in the Meta AI app, and if you go to the live translate feature, you can actually choose what you want people to speak. And if you look at the app, you can set the they speak to English. And then you can set the you speak to Spanish. And that means when you start the live translation, you can be speaking to someone in English, and what they say in English is then translated back into your ears in Spanish. Meaning you can kind of use these to teach yourself Spanish in a way. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold these speakers in front of me, play a YouTube video, and that will effectively be the person speaking English at me, and I should get a live translation into Spanish in my ears. Now I click play.
Uno de los experimentos de pensamiento más considerados en la historia de la humanidad tiene que ser.
I mean, that's pretty cool. It genuinely does work. I don't know how useful that would be, but surely in theory, if you wanted to learn a language, that would help you do it. And as you can see, it knows I'm speaking English and doesn't then auto-transcribe it into Spanish back for the person, because it can tell I'm already speaking English. So you can actually use this just as a one-way conversation for you hearing Spanish. Kinda crazy.
And all of these cool features can actually be used to help people, such as the visually impaired. So let's imagine, for example, someone who's visually impaired has lost something in their house. They can then use the Meta AI app to get in contact with someone who can see the live feed from their glasses. And that person can then effectively be their eyes and help them locate whatever they lost. And I personally think that is so, so cool, and that kind of stuff makes me really excited for this tech and what it can do for people. But there's one more reason I personally really like these glasses, and to explain that, I'm gonna have to head back home. So let's go.
All right, so we are now back in my office, as you can see. And the reason we came back here is because I wanted to show you guys this. This is called a Camp Snap camera. It costs about £40, and it's one of the best purchases I've made in the last couple years. Basically, it's a digital camera that takes vintage style photos like a disposable, but unlike a disposable, you just download the photos onto your computer afterwards, and then you can reuse it over and over again. And just to be clear, this isn't like some secret ad or anything. This video isn't sponsored by Camp Snap or Meta for that matter. I just genuinely really love this camera. And I take this thing with me anytime I go on holiday, to a festival, to weddings, whatever. Have you ever been out with a group of friends and someone wants to take a group photo, so then you all gather up around, it takes a minute for everyone to get ready, you take the photo, and then people start looking at all the photos taken and they're like, no, we didn't get the right shot, someone wasn't smiling, we need to do it all again, and then you're there for like 4 minutes trying to get the perfect photo. Well, if we take a look at this camera here, as you can see, there is no monitor to look at photos after you've taken them. The only time you can look at the photos is when you plug them in and download them onto your computer. And that's the reason I love this camera, because it keeps me in the moment. I take the picture and then I move on. There's no checking 5 times to see if I got the perfect shot. It's just boom, done, moving on. It keeps me in the moment and I love it. And in my opinion, these glasses achieve a similar thing. Before I got these glasses, if I was, say, out with friends and something really funny or amazing was happening, I would have to grab into my pocket, grab the phone, unlock it, go to the camera app, and then click video, and then start videoing. And that's how long it would take. But now that I have these, it's simply, oh, there's something funny going on? Video. And that is personally what I love about these, is because it keeps me in the moment and off of this. Not only when it comes to taking photos and videos, but when I'm also using the AI and doing text and calls too. So, to bring it back to the beginning of this video, do I think these AI glasses are gonna be the future of wearable tech, just like smartwatches were back in the day? And the answer to that is yes, I do. And in fact, I'm really excited to see what comes next. With these, Meta undoubtedly has a head start over Google and Apple. These are their second generation AI glasses. And this excites me because Meta have set the bar now. And in my opinion, they've set that bar pretty high. And that means that the competition is gonna have to raise that bar if they wanna compete. And as we know, competition normally leads to more innovations and more value for us as customers. Because these tech giants are going to battle it out to see who can get the biggest market share over this new technology. And to be honest, we're already seeing this in action. Google just had their conference the other week showing off their version of these glasses, which seemingly can do everything these Meta Ray-Bans can while also having a display in the left lens, which allows you to read text, and if you look down, you can see a map if you're using navigation. And I, for one, am gonna be very interested to see how Meta and Apple respond. So to round things off, do I think you should get a pair of these right now? These are genuinely a great product, and I don't think anyone would regret buying them. But I would say, if you can, hold off on buying them for 6 months to a year, as I really do think we're on the verge of seeing these AI smart glasses exploding in popularity. Thanks for watching. Done!